No way.
Wow. It's like, fuck, I just wanted some muffins.
They taste like raisins. Just picture it's a raisin.
I don't mind raisins. It. I like it. So.
I am picturing it as a raisin. And funny you say, because...
I've been sitting here.
Where is that?
Underworld. Yeah, I'm under.
Drunk
what?
Oh,
there's
the cord.
Oh,
where's the cord?
You got it.
Look behind myself.
I died yesterday in DR.
Yesterday? Why?
I already just died.
Oh.
I was like, God.
Mm-hmm. That's when you gave it to Tyler.
No, yeah, how have we not had midday chip? Yeah, we did.
No, we didn't.
No, we didn't.
From who?
Who did it?
Anyone?
You
want
it?
They smell bad?
No, they don't smell bad. Yes. Oh,
yeah, I grabbed the wrong one.
No. It's because of the spaghetti.
I saw the yoga mats and got
some. Because they got like spaghetti and parmesan on them.
The inside's fine, just the outside's crunchy.
Yeah.
So now they smell like
brutal.
Sunlight. Clean.
When do you drink them?
With the power of sunlight.
Just wash them down.
That? You're trying to get that,
my mind expanded.
Wow, sunlight really made these even better than they were before.
With the power of sunlight?
With the power of sunlight. To that top. With sunlight.
This
and Wendy's. N-O-L-G. And shout out to Weber.
It's star time.
She has such a soothing voice.
Yeah.
It's just the right amount of humor.
Yeah.
I feel like I have.
Oh, do you think?
Yeah.
When? I forget you work for Banana. So
yeah.
A whole lot of stuff.
Got me. You're right.
Yeah, he's a plant.
He's a plant.
He's a plant.
100%.
You're perfect.
Confirmed.
Hey, I'm singing. Some of that crumble.
Leave some for Tina for dinner.
Preheat that oven, get some more going. Make another one.
Well, I didn't finish my bowl.
I know. I'm just saying, make another one.
Oh, God.
It's easy and delicious. Slop is also nutritious. I've been sitting here.
This one's, yeah, this one's the worst out of them all.
Oh, she's dry. You're fucking chewing chicken bones.
Yep.
Well, Skip is in, what, 2 days?
Yeah.
Oh, I forgot about that.
There's some heavy hitters on Slop right now.
100%. I actually don't. It's a toss-up.
That's it is a toss-up.
It is. Because they're not going to see you win your third veto before.
Oh, yeah.
Ah, son of a bitch. That would have been perfect.
Yeah.
Let's go, baby. Tina,
Tina, yeah, she's good, Kim.
Oh, that the crunch. Is it good?
Yeah.
I mean, it's fucking smart. It is what it is.
It'll do.
You don't need a bowl then, do you?
No.
Okay.
Nope, Negatron.
Nope. Okay.
Isn't that napping just like makes you feel like shit all day?
Always, yep.
Right? It needs to be like 10 minutes. Okay, close, bitch.
Let's just put that bowl back.
Yes,
boop.
Beep.
Boop. Nail. much more chill when the outside's open.
Oh, I know, right?
I'm gonna look normal.
Big talking here today? No? At all?
I think. Kind of acting funny, but.
Oh, yeah.
I'm just gonna leave this out for Jen and Toxic one. So no one snap, okay? No one snap.
No one say, hey, I don't care.
You don't give a
I'm
shit.
I'm not eating it.
You chill. You're always chill.
No odds to me. I'm gonna put too much sauce in that then.
Time.
Enjoy, it's nice.
Thanks, crack. Roll back out?
Yeah.
Burn them out off me. On the couch. Different view. All done your workout?
Oh, yeah. Isn't
it? Lovely.
Good.
I don't think I like it with extra salsa on top after it's cooked.
No?
I feel like that's all. I feel like I'm just eating salsa.
Hey girl, hey. I don't know how you guys sit in that heat.
I do it in like chunks.
Yeah, I need either a cold alcoholic beverage or a pool.
No. In the shade, if you're kind of in the shade, it's really nice.
Yeah.
Direct heat is hot.
I wonder what time it is.
By four?
We're saying probably around 4:30 or 5 by the look of the sun.
Yeah, it says 4:04.
What's up, spot?
Hanging out, organizing clothes. But you know it.
Got your clothes done?
No, actually.
No?
I really took my time with this one. I'm gonna get my 2 minutes of fresh air.
See the form?
It looks pretty good, I got to say.
Oh!
Can I give you this? You're going that way?
Mm-hmm.
Drop it in.
Thank you, darling.
I'm boiling the kettle. Do you want anything?
Yes, please.
What do you want?
I'll come over there once it's all whistling.
Charring everything in sight. No vetoes are safe when Rohan's around.
Let's go, baby. Catch the smoke, baby.
Catch that motherfucking smoke.
I was really hoping you threw one of your oven gloves yesterday.
I couldn't do the same celly twice.
Why not?
Just gotta keep it diverse.
There was no selling at first. That was hilarious.
That was fucking too much.
That was the greatest win ever.
It has to be a blooper. It has to be.
This guy just sits there and doesn't even smile.
Even Ro.
Me, Jen, and Beth are like, what is going on?
They're like, who won? And the winner is Rohan.
It's because I was pretty sure. It's because I was pretty sure I won, so. That's why I wasn't surprised.
I'm not surprised, motherfucker.
Yes. Raiden. Do you know who says that?
Wild.
Nate Diaz.
What the fuck?
Let's go. I'm a huge UFC fan.
I'm a huge fan. Okay, well, my boyfriend is, which means I am.
Yeah.
I love Nick and Nate. They're crazy.
You know, my boy saw Nick at the club in Las Vegas.
Yeah.
I would have went nuts.
He DM'd him, and he's like, yo, I saw you last night. He, like, took a picture. And I was like, yeah. And Nick was like, yeah, I saw you, man.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Yeah,
yo,
that's dope.
I'm not surprised.
Yeah, my homies went to the second fight, and they got into a fight with some Conor McGregor fans at the press conference.
Oh,
and then it, like,
God.
Made the news. And I was like, holy fuck. I was like, what are these guys doing?
So his dad is a judge. So he's, like, obviously, he's fully ordained.
Yeah.
So I think he's marrying them, actually.
Oh, shit.
That's what I want to fucking do. I just love joining people in holy matrimony. Weddings are dope.
In holy matrimony.
Nice, man.
Beth, salad was dope.
Thank you.
Sandwiches, salads. What else you got up your sleeve?
What's about it? That's that.
I'm
the lunch girl.
You're the lunch girl. That's perfect.
You've seen up my sleeve. That's all that's there.
It's all that's there. It's empty.
My bag. I got the empty. Breakfast crew, lunch crew,
and dinner.
Dinner crew.
It's actually good.
Hell yeah.
Good shit.
Yeah.
Nice.
That nap made me feel shitty.
Down on the body.
Over here, yeah.
I was out.
Yeah, you were in the zonks.
It felt really good.
All the chins were coming out.
Oh, nice.
I was like, oh, shit.
Love when that shit happens. That was actually me when I was, like, at my grad ceremony, like, my university one. I was like, you know when they put the thing over your head? I was like, I saw the picture. I had, like, 10 chins. I was like, oh. Sweet.
Sweet.
Thank you, sir.
Cold out here in the shade.
Yeah, in the sun, it's really nice.
10 degrees colder in the shade.
Stand here for 1 minute.
You're a rich girl.
My mouth is very cut up from the bagel from breakfast.
Your old man's
that's how my day is.
The bagel cut your mouth?
Fuck.
You toasted it too hard, didn't
don't
you?
Give
it
to Please Sean. Stop singing.
That was in row.
3 points.
That's it. Please stop talking about food.
And I cut my mouth on a bagel.
Yeah, that thing hurt.
Shit, that's my bad. No, that was me. That was me.
I told you guys. Yeah. Toasted.
It's just my eating habits.
I go lightly toasted on everything.
I like my shit pretty toasted.
I seen that.
I like my shit fully torqued.
I like that shit toasted.
Yeah. I like the crunch.
I like it.
I made the crunch too.
Yeah.
Crunch cuts your mouth.
At the sub store?
Yeah.
Sub?
Huh? Double toasted?
Yeah.
Double toasted.
That's crazy.
Is that dry ass toaster?
What?
It dries out all the bread?
Totally.
It does dry it out.
It doesn't really, it's just the outside.
It just gives it a crunch. I love it.
I get my toast.
Yo, you get flatbread?
Flatbread. You guys have the same.
You get BMT?
Flatbread Italian?
Yeah,
BMT? That's cool.
I get that every time.
I get the BMT, but not on the flatbread. I might have to try it now.
It's fucking good.
Veg delight?
Yeah, Italian herbs and
fucking
cheese.
Time, yep.
It's literally just bread and vegetables. What's going on there?
What else do I would eat?
Some meat.
You can get the veggie falafel.
Some meat, he says.
There's falafel. There is falafel.
You can get the seafood medley, bro.
Yeah.
No.
It's disgusting.
Yeah.
Tuna.
The S way.
Friday tuna.
The S way shrimp.
Oh, there is egg.
Yeah, egg salad.
Do they still do
that? Oh my god.
They have the wraps now, don't they?
People look at the egg salad there, I'm like, what are you doing?
That's disgusting.
If I ever made somebody feel that way in this house, I'd feel terrible.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Mm. Like, just so many little digs.
Yeah.
So many where I'm like, why?
No conscience, right?
Well, it's just, I understand this is a game. You have to make hard decisions. You have to make hard choices. You have to make hard moves. Mm. It's just the really like kicking people while they're down that I will not forget.
No.
And they've done it to a lot of people now.
They have.
A lot of people.
Yeah.
So a part of me wouldn't be surprised. If they're toying with us, it just seems like It kind of just feels a little cruel. It's outside of the game now.
If they go that route, yeah.
If they don't, then it all makes sense. And we had to play it cool, and I get it. Mm. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But you still don't. You never forget how people make you feel.
Mm-mm.
And that is an element to the game, jury management.
Like, oh, definitely.
I won't be bitter.
But on my sway.
But if you intentionally make me feel like garbage,
mm-hmm.
you're not getting my vote.
No.
I don't care who's sitting next to you.
Yeah, exactly.
I don't care if you think it's a Florida the whole way through.
Yeah.
If you make people feel like garbage, it's the same reason why the friendship guy lost to Josh.
That's right, yeah.
You're malicious, you kick people when you're down. It doesn't have to be that way.
Mm.
But I would be surprised if Beth... it doesn't make sense for Beth.
It wouldn't because, like...
It doesn't. It really doesn't.
It could blow up a lot of shit on her game.
And a part of me is dying to talk to her and be like, you came here for a reason. You are a smart girl.
Mm.
Do not make your decisions just because you found a cute boy in the house.
She does. She tells me that she's not playing for the guys.
Then good.
And
if she's not playing for the guys, Vic will go up.
Yeah.
Because Vic has directly said on numerous occasions that she's gunning for her heart. She tossed her bag in her room. She tried it. Like, she hasn't hid that.
Mm.
Vic can't even be mad at us. If things blow up, be like...
Backed into a corner. What do you want us to do?
Not even backed into a corner. Those are real things that you did and you said.
Yeah.
Like, would I be in a position where I wouldn't want to divulge that? For sure. But those were your actions. You wanted to toss her bag out. Like,
yeah.
I might make little
And you took her bag to the HOH room.
Yeah. I might make, like, little snippet jokes, but, like, X weren't jokes.
No.
But, I mean... I don't know.
And she kept telling me that she doesn't want to lose another girl Humber in the house. So she told me.
Well, either way a girl would go.
No, I know, but she just she doesn't want to.
I think she knows that Vic wouldn't be a girl that has her back later.
No, I think that's
because what in all honesty, if Beth saves me, I am not looking at Beth.
No.
I'm not. There's only one person that I'm really looking at, and I can't even figure out if I stay, how the fuck to get about. I've been thinking about it for days. How do you do it?
It's gonna be here hard.
You'd want a back door. But the numbers are going. He's probably going to be picked in vetoes.
Mm-hmm.
You put him up flat, right? You know he's taking himself down.
The only way to do it is if both of them were up and stayed up. And even then, it might even be a toss-up.
I think he would gun for those vetoes. He would get them. We've already let him get too far. There were so many shots that could have been taken on him that have been wasted. He could potentially win this game. Because
mm-hmm.
I have been dissecting outs. Who would do it? When would it happen? And I honestly don't see him.
It's not only who would or wouldn't put him up, it's like... comes down to votes.
And I do think he could beat Ty in a physical competition.
I agree. Yep.
And I think Ty's starting to realize that. I honestly don't know how you even get him out. Because the thing is...
If Ty is starting to realize that, it may be a vote.
I don't even want to think about it until we're past this week, but... People are worried about getting rollout. Good looking Jensen out. good luck. We've had so many clean opportunities to do it too.
Nobody wants to put them up.
I'm so mad that I lost that invisible HOH by one run. The game would be totally different.
It would be that would have been a good different. Turning point, that's for sure.
It could ultimately be my final demise. Even though I didn't go that week, it could still be the reason why they win.
There was other opportunities leading up to that, though.
That one was key, though. We had the numbers.
Had the numbers, and nobody would have known.
Invisible HOH power. No blood. I can't. I'm so mad at Nick for doing that. What up, girl? You done?
You done out in the sun?
Is it start? Is the sun starting to go down, though?
Yeah.
Oh, is it?
It's like half of the backyard now.
There was a point where I kind of like figured out in my head with the sloth bass and everything that it was Vic when the knobs went up. And I went into the room and it was just me and her. And I was like, don't even look at me. I'm like, I think this is you. Don't look at me. Don't give me any signs on it. But that was an insane move and I'm proud of you because she put herself up. And it was just like so diabolical. But looking back on it now, I'm like, why? Why was he doing?
Yeah.
Like, Austin was dangerous, but that is a perfect shield.
Yeah, we
would be sitting in a completely, the house would be completely different.
It's not just that week. Everyone knew that it was going to be a threat all along.
I don't know how Keith thinks he's going to beat him.
I don't know. I've noticed a difference in Keith this week.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Huge. I can't explain that. I don't know if Keith is playing because he wants to win or he just wants to see how far he can get. He's not winning against Jensen. Honestly, no one is. Not even Roe. Even it came down to Jensen and Roe. With Roe's resume now, I still think it would be Jensen. How do you get this far? You are never in power, and you have made every single call. How?
They got sway.
It's not even sway. People don't even
charm.
Know. It's not even charm. People don't even like him. Most people.
But he's doing something that works. Then
I know, but that's what I mean. Like, if it came down to him and anybody else, I hate to say it, I would almost be forced to give him my vote. How do you do that? Every conversation we've had with people, it's kind of that they're not like crazy about him. You know, I picture Braden, Austin, Kyle. How many people said he's so cocky, so arrogant?
I don't know.
It's crazy. Our only saving grace is that maybe I do stay. And we just have to go hard, and we can't hesitate. But I still don't see. I don't see how he actually goes. Unless maybe Ro could beat him in a veto comp. Like, unless you legit put up Ro and him and have them duke it out?
You could, but would that be the one that he'd lose, right?
If he, then, like, then say, you're... like, if Jensen wins, because Jensen would go for it. Unfortunately, then you'd either put up Beth or die.
Against Ro.
And then even still, Ro would go because Keith would not vote Ro to stay. Keith fucks us over every time. Keith fucks us over every time. On the vote.
I just don't get it. Keith, the whole while, has been saying he knows he's gonna, the shot's gonna have to be taken.
I guarantee you, if they flip it and it's me and Brayden, he will vote me out. He will be the vote I need and he won't give it to me. It literally comes down to him, I think. I'd obviously have you. Even though Brayden and Ro were close, I feel like I could get Ro. I know I could get Vic. I think it would honestly come down to Kiefer. And that would be the reason why I went. Which is maddening. So maddening. Unless he would finally be ready to stand against him.
Keith doesn't want to show a card, see?
He did show his cards. He told us if it was Ro and Vic up there and the guys told him to vote out Vic, he would vote out Vic. That's showing his cards. When I asked him to keep Ro, he said Ro has got to go. When the boys asked
him. For whatever reason, though, he's stubborn and has a personal vendetta about getting Ro out. He's letting his
He would drop the vendetta for the boys, for Jensen and Ty. He wouldn't drop
if it was Rowan Vic, and he would vote Vic out.
Yeah.
Kiefer, Kiefer, Kiefer.
Do you think Vic can hear us through that hallway?
God only knows. Did she go in that way?
I think so. I feel like you should put it down and just be like, oh, say you were seeing if it was hot in there. We were going to play chess.
I went in and checked Expedia. Not too. She's not in there. She must be up in the age room.
Oh.
Listening to music or something.
The whole house is either playing us or they're playing her.
Hmm?
The whole entire house is either playing us or they're playing her.
Well, I don't fucking know.
I don't see the play on why it makes sense to play us.
No.
Unless they're worried that I'll just go nuts. But I don't think they would care enough. What could I possibly do? If I caused a scene, they would just put you up next to me. Do you know what I mean?
Well, exactly.
I don't know why they would be so worried about me. It doesn't make sense. I just want this freaking ceremony to happen.
It's just happened so we can freaking relax for the rest of the week.
I still don't think it will be relaxing, but it will be better than this limbo.
Well, at least you know that part one is done with the plan. You know that that's what's going in motion.
You get really pretty eyes, Blue Line.
Do I?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Great eyes. Go work some charm with them. Hey, do something with them.
Do something with those damn eyes.
I think they look really blue because of your shirt. I never noticed how blue they are right now. My brother had really blue eyes, the one who passed away.
Him and my mom were the only ones who have, like, really blue eyes in our family.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah, mine can be blue or gray or green.
Mm-hmm. They're very blue right now because your shirt.
It must be the shirt.
Yeah.
Austin said the same thing to me when I had the shirt on.
Yeah. Mm. Yeah.
Look, Canada.
Yeah. But don't vote for her. Yeah, don't skip the dishes.
No, please do.
They're not looking at us.
Camera's that way.
Do you want to know what's so infuriating, too? My brother-in-law is obsessed with the show and always reads the spoilers. And he knows my fate right now, and I don't.
Ooh.
He knows it. Because I don't know where he sees them, but it's like it's a board where the live feeders always write what's going on.
Oh, okay.
So you can kind of pinpoint what will happen and who it looks like is going home. Like, you
based
never really know.
Yeah.
But they pinpoint everything. Like, oh, yeah, this person's sweating or what. Like, he knows and I don't. Pissed. Burn. Send me a sign.
Please and thank
you. The wall crashes. Okay, well, I'm done here.
Yeah, exactly. I'm done. Thanks a lot.
My chair breaks. Tits up.
Tits up. Oh, God. Then I'm crooked as sin for the rest of the week. Oh, God. Oh, if they go back on it, Nasty Tina might have to come out. If she only comes out once or twice a year.
If they go back on it, I just don't understand it. Because
I don't get it.
They didn't need to tell. They didn't need to start this story, right?
Mm-mm.
If they weren't going to do it, why even tell me about it?
Well, if they weren't thinking about the plan, why would they even tell you in row that you were going on the plot?
It's got to be what they're doing. It's got to be.
This game is so weird.
Yeah. Like,
you go 5 minutes from trusting someone to not.
Oh, I trust no one. I trust you the most, and I do. I trust Ro. I know you're not fully there.
I'm not fully there. It's a lot for me to give trust to someone, especially in this environment. Yeah. So, like, the fact that you have 100%.
Yeah. Well, I would say you is 100%, and he's maybe like 90.
Yeah.
Keith's at 70. Hmm. And then it continues to go down. With Jed being at the very bottom, then Beth, then Ty, then Brayden, then, oh, actually, no, Vic would be, it would go Jetson, Beth, Vic, even though I hate saying that, Ty, Brayden, Kiefer, Ro, you, if I had to tier it on trust levels.
Yeah, it'd be you, Kiefer. Everybody else down here.
Yeah. Same. You're all on the same line.
I don't know.
I'm not going to lie to you. If they're kind of pulling the wool over our eyes, I'm like, honestly, then just get me the hell out of here.
No, don't give up.
Oh, I know, but it's like, stop toying with me. I know I'll be on slop again. I know they'll just keep doing this. Well, how much torture can one person take? For real, is it worth it?
That's a lot of torture situations.
Who knows? Maybe my little clothing line is booming right now. I don't even know. Maybe I don't even need 100K. What is going on? How are my girls doing?
Yeah, exactly.
Are sales good or are they not?
That's right.
If sales are good, I'm getting the hell out of here.
I'm getting the hell out of here.
If the sales are shit, I have to stay.
Yeah, I know, right?
Oh, that would be great if that helps that out a little bit. You never know.
I'd be all right.
That would be like a silver lining if I just been tortured for 6 weeks. Oh, wait, this is week 6, right?
Yeah.
Oh, 6 is my least favorite, most unlucky number ever.
Really?
7.
Lucky number 7.
7 is a good number for me.
Oh, that's
6
good.
Has always been a terrible.
Go away.
Yep.
Why is that?
Well, my mom hates the devil. So anything with 6s, because you know, like the 3 6s in a row. So that has been like ingrained as a child. The 6s.
Yeah.
And I want to say my ex-hockey player, I'm pretty sure one of the teams he played for, I think he might have had a 6. Or was
really?
It a 9?
Once we're out of this house, I have to find out who that is.
You probably know him. Do you want to know what's so annoying? I bet you Cher loves him.
Oh, no.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I really want to know now.
Because he played for her favorite team for a long time.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, she probably loves him. If you have a jersey of his hanging in your house, I will throw up everywhere. Oh, God. Just kidding. I don't think that you would. Or I don't know. But as soon as you told me that was Cher's team, I'm like, oh, man, me and Cher were looking really good. Like me. You know, as long as you like me more, Cher. He's a good guy. He's a great guy. Just like me more.
Oh, I can't wait to find out that then. Interesting. But I don't
follow
hockey.
But yeah, my mom is always like, she hates the number 6. So it's kind of like just been, it's a sign of the devil.
I hate 13.
It's a sign of the devil, and the devil's running the situation.
Yeah, exactly.
If they do some evil shit, that is like.
Yeah. You are a devil.
The trio on week 6.
Sly bunch, man.
So sly.
Yeah. You can see them reading you. Ty sits there and he reads people.
Oh, yeah.
It's creepy.
They're just weighing out who is a bigger threat to them. As they should.
I think Ty is way more closer to Vic. I think he's kind of a little bit more upset about the situation. I don't think.
Yeah, with what
I don't
he
think
has
Jed or Beth. Like, I think Beth may be leaning towards. I think Jed's gonna go along with it because. But I think Ty does
be
want
a little
because.
Bit careful with that, if that's the case. Because I always had a preference of him over the other. That if he could potentially be on the other side being like, don't do it. Send
Ty?
Him. Yes.
I think that's what's going on. I don't think he wants Vic to go. I guarantee that. He has a way closer relationship to Vic than the other two. And he's very calculated in how he maneuvers. Mm-hmm. Conversation?
Yeah.
Which is very dangerous. But it just depends on how much Beth is going to keep her foot down about it. Jed's kind of the middle person, I think, in this conversation. So I don't know. We'll see.
Good thing is that Braden's kind of in Beth's ear too.
Do I what?
That Braden is kind of in Beth's ear.
I don't know. I don't know who to trust in this game.
No one.
All sneaky.
Well, there's literally nothing we can do.
I just wish the POV ceremony would just happen and be done.
1,000%, I agree. The longer it is, the worse it makes the situation where they could change their minds.
Yep. Yep. They could change their mind very quickly.
You can feel that Kiefer's distant, though. He would normally be with us.
Mm-hmm. Which I don't understand. That's what's making me a little sketched out about. I don't know why he... Maybe he's doing it because... I mean, Ty literally split the 3-3.
Mm-hmm.
And he put me, you, and Kiefer at a 3. So unless he's purposely doing that to distance,
mm-hmm.
so that it's not as obvious, maybe.
Yeah, or maybe he's like, if he put up a little bit of an argument for me, maybe he's worried that it would put a target on him.
Yep.
Like, why does he want to keep her safe?
I don't know.
I gotta go fold some laundry.
Sounds like fun.
It's got a bunch of best stuff in there too. It could be nice. I'll fold her crap for her. I have nothing else. I have no other place. This sucks. It's just so frustrating when you think you're gonna come in and play a game a certain way.
And it doesn't go that way?
Like, straight up, my strategy going into... First of all, I thought I would win more shit. I honestly did.
Yeah, so did I.
Because, like, I know that I'm small, but I'm in pretty good shape right now. Do you know what I mean? Like, I'm probably in the best shape that I've ever been in my life. And I thought maybe being small would help out in some things. Like, little quick.
Yeah.
Little quick little mouse. Don't even see me coming. And my initial strategy... Because now we'll just share. My initial strategy, and it's kind of what I do in life... is, you know, always making people think it's their idea. Mm. Like, when I want my husband to do something, I have to figure out a way to get him to think that he thought of it so that he'll actually do it, right? And I do it all the time. But in this house, I wasn't able to build up those connections with people because that's kind of like Jetson's game.
Yeah.
Like that. Like, he's got that down to a T. When there's already one person that's kind of doing it and running the show, you can't do it.
No.
And then my other strategy... would be to partner up with one person. I wanted an alliance of three. Mm. One person who's very physical and one person who's very smart.
Mm.
And I actually feel like me, you, and Ro could be that triangle.
Mm.
I thought I'd be much more of like a strategy mastermind.
Yeah.
Like the pieces. You know, like if we do this move, and then... which could still happen.
Oh, yeah. It could.
That could be, because, like, somebody like Ro could be very useful for us.
Oh, for sure.
Initially, when I walked into the house, like, the first day, I thought for sure it would be Ty and Kiefer. Mm. Like, those were the three that I really wanted. Like, the two.
Yeah.
Just by first look. Impressions.
Yeah.
I was like, Ty is the powerhouse I need. And for some reason, Kiefer just looked really smart to me. Like, I'm like, this guy's going to know his numbers. He's going to know his shit.
Yeah. And he does.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
And if we could survive it, or if they do get rid of Ro, and we could bring in Ty to our four, that's a good spot. It could still...
You just got to get past this fucking week.
Got to get past this one first. Mm-hmm. And there's a lot of ways that I'm seeing it. There's a lot of ways I'm seeing it where I could survive. And there's a lot of where I see that I don't.
Mm.
And all of them, zero control.
That's the shitty part, when you don't have control of a situation.
None.
I hate that.
None.
Hate it.
But if we can survive this, I do think we can make it to the end. But every single move after this, my conversations need to go right down. Because I fully asked. Actually, when I chatted with Beth, I did ask her. I'm like, why do you think everybody's like saying my name over Tina's? She's like, why do you want me to put Tina? I was like, no, don't go twisting.
Let's not twist it.
Yeah. I'm like, no, absolutely not.
Yeah.
I'm just asking why it's easier for people to say my name. Just for my own personal.
Yeah.
Because I can't figure it out.
Oh, I can't figure it out.
And she said to me, and she's like, well, honestly, when you're in rooms, you talk more than Tina.
And really?
Like, yep. And I was like, that's fair. Like, I need to be mindful of that.
That's what she said.
Yep.
Interesting.
She's like, you talk more than Tina. So, like, she's like, Tina sit backs and chills. You talk more than her. But I think that's good for you. I think it makes them think that I'm the one making the decisions. Do you know what I mean?
Mm.
Which isn't true.
Mm.
But she did say that. So if we can survive this week, I got to button that right up.
I'll tell you, shut up.
Yeah.
No problem. I can do that.
I need to.
I tell
more.
People to shut up all the time.
Yeah. We should have a safe word. For real. Yeah. If you just hear me going off, like a safe word to be like, okay, like reel it in slowly. Because I do. I talk all the time.
Oh, that's okay.
Yeah. But I can see how for some of them, it's not like I'm talking a lot to try and build up trust. But for them, they're using that against me.
Interesting.
You can't give them things that they can use against you. But it will be very tricky to figure out. Because we're in a position where we need to start winning. But they are very threatened by people who win. It's very delicate.
They are. That's why if Ro actually gets the next HOH, it would be better for
that
us.
That would be best case scenario. Hands down, best case scenario.
Yep.
Hands down.
And Brayden says that if he gets it, he's going to take a shot. I would believe it. Ro would do it first before Brayden, but again, I don't know.
I think Brayden would, but there would still be an opportunity where I could see the block again. But I think he would be.
Yeah.
Just because I don't think he would touch Beth.
No, I don't think so.
I could see him putting up both guys. And then if one came down, me as a replacement. Or maybe Kiefer, actually.
Maybe.
I don't know.
Because he's not really in tight with Kiefer.
Yeah. Row is hands down best case scenario.
Yeah.
But I also don't like feeling like I got no control.
No, I know. At least if you have the power, it's your decision.
And at least it's like if we start getting power, we just can't lose it.
Mm-mm.
It's going to be an uphill battle if I even get out of this week. Because I look at it a lot of ways, and there's a lot of scenarios where I go home.
Well, let's just hope that doesn't happen.
Yeah. If I feel like it is me going home, though, we're just going to have to figure out how to set you up best. That's it.
Well, worry about that as it gets closer. I mean, yeah. You know, if Dick goes up, if that happens, then I truly believe you're not going home.
Yeah. Even that bothers me.
No, they wouldn't risk putting her off.
No, I mean, even being in the position of me sitting next to Vic and her story.
I know.
I'm pissed at them. I'm so mad at them. Like, I know she's spicy and she's unpredictable, but, like, that girl's got a story. She's here for a reason.
Yeah.
That makes me feel like garbage. If I've got something to do with why she's going home, and they do that shit on purpose.
Yeah, I know, it's...
But I'll have to.
This is the shitty part of the game, right? Because when you get to a certain point, you know people enough where...
Every single person that goes.
Yeah.
Every single person. I mean, honestly, even starting with Josh. Josh was really good for my game.
Yeah.
I did feel like Ro would have been better. Which might have been the right call, because Ro's crushing it. LaToya, I felt like garbage saying her name. Kyle, felt terrible saying his name. Kyle was so good for our game. Austin, didn't have a crazy personal relationship. She was great for our game.
It's funny, you know, I started building more of a personal relationship with her at the last when she was up.
I had some really good moments
so
with her.
It's so unfortunate.
Yeah. I had some really good moments with her, like, at the end. Yeah. Like, even, like, saying, like, goodbye to her and stuff.
Yeah.
That's what makes this game hard, just seeing, like, all the people that you want to be working with
go through the doors.
One by one.
Yeah.
And having not being able to do anything about it. Honestly, because of one person who's making all the shots.
It's amazing how one person can have that much power.
Holy crap. All he's done is one veto.
I know.
I don't even know how people were not looking at him
that first week.
Yeah, that blew my mind because there was no relationships built then. That would have been the prime opportunity.
Even the second week.
It's like, no, he's off limits. They were doing that because
of
team
decision.
When I
floated it to Austin, because that was real. Of course I covered it up. Like, oh, like he's safe. Mm. I was for sure feeling her out on that. And he is the reason she went home.
Yeah.
He's the reason everybody went other than LaToya and Josh.
Mm.
Even Josh. Well, they wouldn't have the votes anyway, but you know he's like, just make it unanimous.
Mm.
He's playing a good game. A good game. He's playing the game I thought I was going to play.
I think we all thought that coming in.
Holy. He would be so good on that challenge show. I would root for him.
I've seen the commercials for it.
Oh.
It looks like a
that show was meant for him.
Yep.
Oh my God. He would do so well. I'd be stoked to see him on it too. I only don't like him in the house. I do like him as a person. It's just in here that he drives me insane.
Yeah, exactly.
Outside, outside, I'd be like, yeah, that's my hot friend, Jed. You know?
That's right. Yeah.
The house is so weird, though, because look at
it. It's what?
The house is so weird. Me and you are here. Vic is off hiding by herself, and they're all outside. And because Ro has the video, he's allowed to be out there now, too.
Yeah, if he didn't have the video, he'd be in here.
He'd be on a couch by himself as well.
Yeah, I just can't deal with all of them all at once at 24/7.
Yeah, it's a lot. Should we go fold that laundry and then go for a dirt?
Sure.
You don't have to help me fold it, but
don't worry.
Or unless, like, I don't know if you, like, want to, like, hang out with anybody else.
You're like, no, you're kind of my favorite person in the house.
You're totally my favorite person. 1,000%.
Whoa. All right,
I'm gonna go start folding them.
Yep. Be up in a minute.
Yep, yep.
done that. That is so funny. Put a little note in between. Yeah. Oh, you what's your name?
Final two question mark.
Alliance.
Yeah, I was always wondering who had the waves.
The West Coast Warriors.
Yeah. Maybe just
that's so funny that you didn't like them together.
No, I was so pissed.
The weights that I was given were like old school dumbbells that felt like they had sand in them.
Were they black and white?
Right? I didn't have those.
No. So I actually
you
was
asked
not
for like
doing...
the heavier weights or the other ones.
I don't even know. I feel like mine.
I had those
like,
keep right a few times.
I feel like, I don't know. Do you think they shared them throughout the floors?
The red and black ones?
Yeah. Did you have those?
Yeah, I had those.
No, I never had the red and black. Mine were just like black. And they had tape all over them.
Oh, no. So I was probably different.
What floor were you on?
Eight.
Oh, well, I was on nine, so I don't know.
I'm on six.
Anyone out here on eight?
Two.
You were on eight?
So I'm like, fuck me, I take this huge barbell up the elevator.
You weren't even in there. You were working, setting.